It bailed out on us, and I had to go right back in.
It is going.
Yeah, it's going now, but it
Thank you.
you would now please join me in the call to worship, reading responsibly. Though there are rulers, presidents, kings, and queens, God is the Lord of life.
In God we live and move and have our being.
God requires our faithfulness and our service.
We reach out to others with the same kind of love with which God has touched our lives.
Come, let us worship the Lord, who is always with us.
Let us praise God, who walks daily by our side. Amen.
And now we come to that time in our service where we give thanks to God for our offerings. And remember that the plate's in the back of the church. If you'd like to place your offering in the plate, that would be great. If you would like to mail in your offering to the church, the address is on our Facebook page this morning. You can mail it into that address, or you can even drop it by the office. You can drop it by the secretary's office or even on my desk. Just put it in the envelope and write offering on it, if you would. So let us thank the Lord for our blessings. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning with thankful hearts. We are so thankful for your love and for your forgiveness. We are so thankful for your grace and for your wisdom. We are thankful for all that you have done for us and all that you provide for us each and every day. So now, as a love offering, we give back to you. We give back because we love you, especially because we know that you love us. So please accept this offering as a love offering from us. Please bless it, and please multiply it, and please use it for your glory, for your honor, and for your praise. All this we ask in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
this morning? Awesome. Do we have any joys in the house this morning? Boy, y'all are quiet. Mm-hmm. Well, it's a joy to have all of y'all here this morning. Lord,
hear our prayers.
Do we have any concerns we need to lift up this morning?
Right?
Definitely, right. Lord,
hear our prayers.
Any other concerns this morning?
We ask for travel mercies for our young woman who's out today. She's in traveling, trying to get home.
Sarah?
Yes, Sarah. Yes, sir.
Lord,
hear our prayers.
Also, we want to continue to pray for Bob and Peggy Steger. And continue to pray for Lori Swepston and John Swepston for their healing. Lord,
hear our prayers.
Anybody else? We all are quiet us this morning. Okay, well then let's go to the Lord in prayer. Almighty God, it is a privilege to come to you. It's a privilege to know that you love us so much that you want us to come to you in prayer. That no matter where we are, what we're doing, we can always talk to you. And Lord, if we'll pause and be quiet and listen, you talk to us too in many different ways. And Lord, you've heard each concern, each joy that we've lifted up loud this morning. And you've heard the ones that we've lifted up in our hearts. And you care about each and every one. That's amazing, Lord. That's just a special love that you have for us. And we're so thankful for that. And you loved us so much that you sent your son to walk among us, to show us that love, to teach us your wisdom, and to teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
the house this morning. I believe we've got one.
The first line in prayer is, "Our Father, who art in heaven." Well, that's pretty self-explanatory. Our Father, God, who's in heaven. That's where He is. That's where we all hope to be someday. All right, here's a tough one. Hallowed be Thy name. What is hallowed? Well, I looked it up in the dictionary. And they had a long line of other big words that said what hallowed meant. And I thought, well, how can I say this where a kid's going to understand it? How about big, huge, special? I mean, beyond special. Every kid knows what special is. Hallowed, hallowed, that's a special name. It's a blessed name. It's a glorious name. It's a holy name. So when you hear hallowed, think the most special thing, the most special name ever. Thy kingdom come is the next line. Thy means God. What about a kingdom? We don't have many kingdoms here on the earth anymore. A kingdom is a place that is ruled by a king. Well, you hear over and over that Jesus is the King, or that God is the King of heaven. So when they're talking about thy kingdom come, maybe that's heaven to come. But God's kingdom is also here, on earth, with us. With us. Thy will be done. What do you think that means? Whatever God's got planned, we hope His plan is carried out. So we want God's will, whatever it is, for my life, for your life, for our country, we want God's will to be done. More than my will, God's will. All right, where do we want His will to be done? On earth as it is in heaven. Well, we know God's in heaven, so of course, heaven's going to be doing everything God wants to have happen here on earth. We kind of get in the way of God's will sometimes, don't we? But we want God's will to be here, too. The next part's pretty easy. Give us this day our daily bread. What do you think that doesn't mean? I want a new bicycle. I would like to have a steak for dinner every day. I would like to have a new car. Or win the lotto. Give us this day our daily bread. Think back about when Moses was walking in the Sinai. God delivered bread every day. Not a whole bunch of bread for 5 days in a row, but enough bread for one day. So we are asking for God to give us this day our daily bread. Not next week, not next month, but this day. And we can rely on that. God will provide. All right, the next part's pretty tough. And we forgive up and forgive us as our trespassers. What's a trespass? Well, in legal terminology, is if I go out to David Wilson's ranch and I don't call him and say, can I come? And I go out there and I start walking around. That's technically trespassing because I didn't ask for permission. Well, that's the legal term. Trespass also means if I do something bad to someone, that's a trespass. If I hurt someone's feeling, if I talk ugly to Lynn, that's a trespass. If I hit somebody, that's a trespass. So all that means is things that we do, the sins we do, God forgives. But what about the sins maybe Lynn did to me? I have to forgive that. Right? So trespass is just another word for our sins, their sins, everybody's sins. All right. And we've got to forgive those who sin against us. Now the next part's a little tough. And lead us not into temptation. Well, there's a couple different ways to think about that. Does God lead us into temptation? No. But there is someone in the world that does. The devil leads us. And he whispers in our ear and says, tells us things, naughty things we might do. And it's up to us to rely on God to help us to not go into temptation. Next part, but deliver us from evil. We can always rely on God to help us in bad times, in hard times, in tough times, and when people treat us ugly. All right, the next part. For thine is the kingdom. Here's that word again, kingdom. For thine, God. It's God's kingdom. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Power. Well, when we read the Bible and we learned about all the miracles that God did when Moses was getting the Israelites out of Egypt, talk about power. The power it took to open the sea, the power it took to just drop bread, little flakes of bread. That's the power. And the glory, when we see the sun come up in the morning and it go down at night, you can see God's glory in the skies. When the birds fly by, you can see God's glory as they fly by. When you go out deer hunting and you see that deer majestically walking across, that's God's glory. And when we see your smiling face here every Sunday, that's God's glory. Forever and ever. That means not just today or tomorrow or next week or next year, but that means forever, for all time. And then the last word, amen. So, the next time you say or hear the Lord's Prayer, think about what it really means. Because a lot of times we say it so fast, and it's kind of, we just blurt it out, and we don't really think in our hearts what this prayer means. And this prayer is real important because it's one Jesus himself gave us to say. This is Jesus' prayer. All right. There's a little prayer here on the back that it suggests for children to pray, kind of a shorthand version of the Lord's Prayer. So I'm going to say it. Let's close our eyes. Dear God, thank you for letting us talk to you. Thank you for your words in the Bible. Help us to use your special instructions to pray and to obey your wonderful commands. Thank you for your love. We love you, God. Thank you for Jesus, and in his name, amen. All right, we're done.
May it be so. Amen?
Amen.
And thank you, Brenda. We do tend to say that quite quickly and probably don't think about it too much. And I think we should think about it more often. Now, if you would, please stand. We'll join together in our affirmation of faith. You'll find that in the bulletin. Let us join together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. They were taken from Jerusalem and taken back to Babylon. And they were forced to go to school to get ready to become servants in his kingdom. And in the last chapter, we saw that God had given Daniel wisdom. The king had ordered special food for them to eat. And it was food that Daniel didn't believe that was healthy and prescribed by God. So he was very tactful in how he overcame that obstacle. God gave him the wisdom to do so. Now, in this chapter, it begins with the king having some troubling dreams. In fact, they're disturbing him so much that he can't even sleep. So he calls together his enchanters, his magicians, his astrologers, and asks them to interpret the dream. But he doesn't tell them what the dream is. He expects them to already know and then interpret it. And they tell him, "O king, no king in history has ever asked a man to do such a thing. You know, only the gods in heaven, you know, could do, you know, what you're asking for." It made him angry. So he told them, "Okay, you know, if you can't do this, then you know, I'm going to have all of you killed. And I'll turn all of your houses to rubble." And so what's actually happened is they've lost favor in the king's eyes. You know, and they're about to lose their lives because of it. This is where we're at in the chapter as I begin. The scripture that we're going to read today is Daniel chapter 2, verses 14 through 23. That's on page 820 in the red Bible in front of you. It's on page 1005 in the blue Bible if you'd like to follow along. And as always, I would remind you to not let anything distract your mind whenever you hear the word of God proclaimed especially aloud. Ask God to speak to your heart and to your mind the message that you need to hear from him this day. So hear what the word says. When Arioch, the commander of the king's guard, had gone out to put to death the wise men of Babylon, Daniel spoke to him with wisdom and tact. He asked the king's officer, "Why did the king issue such a harsh decree?" Arioch then explained the matter to Daniel. At this, Daniel went to the king and asked for time so that he might interpret the dream for him. Then Daniel returned to his house and explained the matter to his friends, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. And he urged them to plead for mercy from God, from the God of heaven concerning this mystery, so that he and his friends might not be executed with the rest of the wise men of Babylon. During the night, the mystery was revealed to Daniel in a vision. Then Daniel praised the God of heaven and said, "Praise be to the name of God forever and ever. Wisdom and power are his. He changes times and seasons. He sets up kings and deposes them. He gives wisdom to the wise and knowledge to the discerning. He reveals deep and hidden things. He knows what lies in darkness, and light dwells with him. I thank and praise you, O God of my fathers. You have given me wisdom and power. You have made known to me what we asked of you. You have made known to us the dream of the king." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks
be to God. Now, here Daniel is. One of the king's officers has come to kill him and his friends. He doesn't understand. Now, if somebody came to me and told me, "Okay, the king's ordered all the wise men, and you're one of them, to be killed," my reaction would be panic. I guarantee you. But that's not what happened with Daniel. Instead, Daniel remained calm, and he wisely assessed the situation. He asked the officer, "Okay, what's going on here? Why did the king make such a decree?" And the officer explained it to him. So then, he didn't tell the officer, "Okay, go back and tell the king, wait a minute, you know, maybe I can do something for him." Instead, he left and he went directly to the king himself out of respect. And he asked the king for some more time. And then what did he do? The first thing he did is he went back to the house and he called together his friends and he called a prayer meeting. He said, "Okay, guys, we need to pray. We need to ask God for help. We need to ask God for his mercy in this situation. We need to ask God for his favor. We need to ask God to show us what we need to do in this situation so that we can survive." He didn't pray for a vision. He prayed for God's favor. He prayed for God's will because he knew that God's will was perfect and that God's way was perfect. And what happened then? That night, in a dream, God gave him the vision of the king's dream. The one that the king expected his enchanters and astrologers to already know. But there was no way they could. But amazingly, God gave Daniel this dream, and he gave it to him in detail. And he also gave him the interpretation. When he woke up the next morning, what did he do? The first thing he did this morning was get up and praise God. Get up and praise God for what he had done. Get up and thank God for giving him this vision. Then, after he thanked the Lord, after he had given him praise, then he went to the king. And the first thing that he says to the king is, no man could reveal this mystery to you. No man. Only the God of heaven could do this. Understand what's happening with this dream. The God of heaven is showing you the future. The God of heaven is showing you what will happen in the days to come. And he said, as for me, this mystery has been revealed to me, not because I have greater wisdom than the other living men, but so that you, O King, may know the interpretation and understand what is going through your mind. In other words, I'm not wiser than any other man, any of your enchanters or your astrologers or any of those men in your court. God is. And God has revealed to me the details of your dream. And then he spoke the details of the dream to him so that he would know that God had given him his favor. He said, in your dream, you've seen an enormous statue. And that statue has a head of pure gold. His chest and arms are made of pure silver. And the belly and the thighs are made of bronze. And the legs are made of iron. And the feet are made partly of iron and partly of clay. And while you see this statue, you also see a rock that's cut out of the earth. But it's not cut out by human hands. It's a rock that's been cut out by God. And that rock strikes the feet of the statue. And the statue is demolished and blown away. And then the rock becomes a huge mountain. In fact, it's so big that it covers all of the earth. That is what you have seen in your dream. And then he interprets the dream for the king. He said, O king, God has given you power and glory, for you are a mighty king. You are the head of gold. But your kingdom will perish, just as the statue was demolished. And after your kingdom, there's three more kingdoms that will come, and they too will perish. And then God will raise up another kingdom that will never be destroyed. It will crush those kingdoms, and it will reign forever. You see, that kingdom is the rock cut out of the mountain by God's hands. And the king was so overwhelmed that he fell at Daniel's feet. He saw that God had placed his favor upon Daniel, that God had given him amazing wisdom, that God had revealed this dream not only to Daniel, but also to the king without him even telling anybody what this dream was. So he fell at his feet, and he said to Daniel, he said, surely your God is the God of gods, and the Lord of kings, and the revealer of mysteries, for you are able to reveal this mystery to me. I think it's important that we remember how this happened. The first thing that happened was Daniel didn't panic. When the king's officer told him, okay, you're fixed to be murdered, he didn't panic. Instead, he remained calm and he assessed the situation. He asked what was going on. And then he called a prayer meeting. Prayer was very, very important to Daniel. It was very, very important to his friends. And he and his companions prayed. And they prayed earnestly. They prayed for God's wisdom, for God's mercy, and for God's favor, and for God's will. Now, prayer is vital to us. Would you agree? You know, Jesus told us in Matthew 7:7, he said, "Ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and the door will be opened to you. Ask, and it will be given to you." If you ask with a sincere heart for God's answer, for God's will, just as Daniel received what he was asking for, you too, we too, will receive God's answer. And in Psalm 145, verses 17 through 18, the word says, "The Lord is righteous in all his ways." In other words, he's perfect, he's right, he knows what's best. "And the Lord is faithful in all he does." In other words, the Lord cares about us that much. Just as he cared about Daniel and his companions, that he was faithful to show them the way and faithful to help them through the situation. "And the Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth." You see, the Lord, I mean, Daniel and his companions knew this, especially Daniel. I mean, he believed it with all his core. And he knew that he had to go to the Lord if this situation was going to be resolved. And he knew that he needed support. He didn't just pray by himself. He also went to his other friends, to the other believers that were with him. And they prayed earnestly, deeply together. Even Jesus needed support. Remember? He took his disciples with him when he went and prayed in the garden and the drops of blood fell from his forehead. He said, "Come and pray with me." And because Daniel and his friends prayed so earnestly, because they were so faithful, God answered that night. Now, that doesn't always happen. You know, it could take 5 years to get the answer. I can tell you that from experience. But it comes in God's time, in God's perfect time. And God's time was that night, and his answer was that vision. And then, when Daniel got up, as I said before, he didn't just jump up and go to the king. Well, he did it. He jumped up and he went to the Almighty King and gave him praise and gave him the thanks that God deserves. Do we always do that when we get that answer? Do we remember to give God praise and give God thanks? You see, when we do that, that does something in here. And it does something in here. And it does, it draws us even closer to the Lord. It builds that relationship, strengthens that relationship that God has with us. So Daniel praised and he thanked God. And then he was obedient. And he went to the king and he shared what God had given him. But he didn't take the credit. He gave God the credit that God deserves. He told the king, he said, "I am no wiser than any other man, but God in heaven is. And God is doing this for your benefit and for mine. He's showing his favor that we may know he is Almighty God. And he always is there for us." And not only Daniel and his companions were saved that day, because he told the king, "You know, this is the true interpretation. You know, please don't kill all the wise men in your court." And all the wise men were saved, along with Daniel and his companions. Why did it happen? Because Daniel and his companions were faithful. Because Daniel and his companions knew the favor of God. Knew that God would provide for them. Even in this extremely dangerous situation. You have to understand, once the king made a decree, it was supposed to happen. Once he said, okay, these wise men are worth nothing. They can't tell me what my dream is. They can't interpret it. They've lost favor in my eyes. Have them put to death. That was supposed to happen. But it didn't happen because of the favor of God. Amen? In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, we give you thanks for your favor. We give you thanks for your love. We give you thanks for your wisdom and for your guidance. Lord, help us to remember, no matter what's going on in life, no matter how bad things might seem, no matter how dangerous things might seem, you're there with us. Remind us to come to you, to seek your presence, to seek your will. And Lord, we pray and ask for your guidance. Help us to be patient and mindful and wait upon you. For your time is perfect, and your way is perfect, and your will is perfect. So Lord, guide us, bless us, love us, empower us, use us to spread your favor all over this world. And we'll remember to give you all the glory and the praise and the honor for it. All these things we ask in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Our closing hymn this morning, when you come at number 364 in your United Methodist hymnal, if you would please rise as you would. We'll be singing verses 1, 2, and 3, Because He Lives.
prayer in the bulletin. Also, I put the dismissal prayer on the Facebook page. If you'd like to pray that with us, this is a prayer we've been praying together every day for quite a while. And it's a prayer where we've been asking God to show us and work through us to bring Jesus' glory into this world more and more. Amen?
Amen.
And something I forgot to say earlier during our prayer concerns is there's an email on the Facebook page that you can use to send any prayer requests to us, and we can give those prayer requests to our prayer team for you, or you can put them in the comments on the video, and we would love to pray for you. So now let us pray together. Oh God, by the grace of Jesus Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit, revive and encourage me to be the servant leader you are calling me to be. Empower me to proclaim the good news of Jesus' life-changing love. Break through to renew and revive our churches. Do what we ourselves cannot do. In Jesus' name, amen. You expect an answer from that prayer?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to the day. Amen.
Amen.
So now let us sing. He wants you to have that favor. So have a blessed and safe week. And if there's any way I can help you, my contact information is on the Facebook page. God bless you, and have a safe week.
Amen.